But as you know, I've been saying for months that one reason the Albanese Labor government might go to the polls later this year rather than early next year is our electricity crisis. I've argued that Labor must know that we've been lucky to have two mild summers in a row, because if we get a normal summer in southeastern Australia especially, a bit of a heat wave in late January or February, we're likely to run out of power. Our renewables push has made us very vulnerable. Lots of power when the wind is blowing and the sun is shining, but not enough reliable, dispatchable power. We saw a few power shortages in Victoria and South Australia last summer, but a proper hot summer spell when our electricity demand peaks is likely to see blackouts and load shedding, especially if there's a lull in the wind. So that's one reason I reckon Labor might want to an election before Christmas. If we had an energy chaos in February, it'd cruel the pitch for an election for them in autumn. Anyway, there was more wind beneath the wings of this theory today, if you like, when the Australian Energy Market Operator released a special update, and it's all bad news. There'll be even less power available than they hoped, and New South Wales, Victoria and South Australia are looking at power shortages in the coming summer and for years to come, depending on what generation and storage is added, of course. AEMO has put out an urgent call for investment to shore up our electricity supplies. Better late than never, hey? Now, AEMO shoulders much of the blame here. They've been all in on this renewable zealotry, and their proposed solution is more renewables and more transmission. This continues the energy self-harm. What we need, obviously, is dispatchable power, power that's there when we need it, regardless of the weather. Still, just remember, when you do get blackouts and power bill increases keep going up, remember the government's been warned time and time again, and that Chris Bowen has been in denial, arrogantly declaring, "She'll be right."
There were no blackouts caused by a lack of electricity. We had issues with cyclones and transmission towers falling over. That can happen to anyone. But we had plenty of energy to get us through last summer, and the investments will come forward, particularly underpinned by the Albanese government's capacity investment scheme.
Righto. Why would we doubt them, hey? Labor's got it under control. Let's see if they have the courage then, the courage of their convictions, and they leave the election till next year.